Dasein is a being in the world, and thus, in understanding its own being, it has a tendency to do so in terms of the world. Therefore, the way Dasein understands the world has an effect on how it understands itself. As a consequence, Dasein's understanding of itself is prone to mutation as its views about the world change. In other words, there are many perspectives from which Dasein can be interpreted and understood, and in understanding ourselves, we rely upon understanding the world from a given perspective. Moreover, there are various fields of study as ways of interpretation which we can also use to understand Dasein, and that's why we might end up with a different interpretation when we apply ethics to Dasein than when we apply physics, biology, or what have you. Nevertheless, in applying these various methods, we cannot have existential justification unless we adequately work out the basic structures of Dasein, and it is the task of Heidegger's existential analytic to work out these basic structures. For this reason, Heidegger considers an analytic of Dasein as the first requirement in the question of being. But he cannot allow any random way to access Dasein. Inspired by Kierkegaard, Heidegger realizes that the most basic way in which Dasein can be is in its average everydayness. What Heidegger calls everydayness, Kierkegaard calls the immediate stage. It is in Dasein's everydayness that Heidegger seeks to access Dasein in order to discover its structures. Interestingly enough, later on, Heidegger will go on to criticize Dasein, which is again something he took from Kierkegaard. According to Kierkegaard, everydayness leads to what he calls leveling. Not surprisingly, leveling or averageness is yet another idea that Heidegger took from Kierkegaard. The reason why everydayness can lead to leveling is that, in its everydayness, the subject does not reflect on himself critically and consciously. In its everydayness, the subject is not capable of doing anything other than mindlessly following the crowd. For Kierkegaard, it is quite simple to level all existence to the idea of the state or the idea of a society. The difficult thing, however, is to become an individual. Heidegger takes this idea and applies it to his analysis of being with, which is to say, Mitsein. Let's return to Heidegger's being and time. Historicality plays an important role for Heidegger. The historical unity of Dasein is not a mere sum of actual experiences, nor even a framework that contains various experiences. Rather, Dasein at each moment carries its past, which is to say thrownness, and future, which is to say death. Previously, we said that the way Dasein understands the world has an effect on how it understands itself. Historicality is something similar, because not only does Dasein understand itself in terms of the world, but it also falls prey to the tradition of which it has more or less explicitly taken hold. This tradition is what it has inherited from the past. Tradition is taken as something self-evident, and this is an obstacle which prevents Dasein from inquiring without prejudgments. As you well know, Husserl thought we can bracket the world in a pure way, but based on this Heideggerian interpretation, the Husserlian epoche is simply not possible as Husserl proposed it. Heidegger wants to destroy the traditional content of ancient ontology in order to arrive at those primordial experiences in which we achieved our first ways of determining the nature of being. But he does not want to destroy absolutely everything. Rather, he wishes to destroy the negative possibilities and maintain the positive possibilities of tradition. In investigating the question of being, Heidegger uses phenomenology as a methodological conception. This expression does not characterize the what of the objects of philosophical research as subject matter, but rather the how of that research. Heidegger defines phenomenology as a maxim which can be formulated as to the things themselves. It is opposed to all free-floating constructions and accidental findings. It is opposed to taking over any conceptions which only seem to have been demonstrated. It is opposed to those pseudo-questions which parade themselves as problems, often for generations at a time. Yet this maxim, one may rejoin, is abundantly self-evident, and it expresses, moreover, the underlying principle of any scientific knowledge whatsoever. Strangely, Heidegger claims phenomenon is something that looks like, but in actuality is not what it gives itself out to be. Therefore, the appearance of something does not mean showing that something. Appearing is a not showing itself. Rather, appearing is an announcing itself. As bizarre as phenomenology is, Heidegger claims we need it to access ontology. As he puts it, only as phenomenology is ontology possible. We need phenomenology because just as biology is the science of living organisms, phenomenology is the science of the being of entities, which is to say, ontology.